Hi, people of God, this is the Sheep of the Good Shepherd 26. Here today to share some pictures and read from some holy scriptures, or just let you read it as I slowly move the screen for you to view it. Look at that one for now. What does that look like? Tell me. Bless you all. Check out the slideshow. An eagle. Dolphin. The zebra way over there. Check out what kind of tree that is. That's beautiful. See that again. Camera doesn't quite do it justice, but it's nice. Anyways, check out the other ones. Those are clouds. So that's part of what I have to share. Share this video. Others can come to Jesus Christ by faith in the gospel. Check out these this rhinoceros. The rhinosaurus. Check it out again. Played in super slow motion. Super slow motion. One more time. Gigantic. Oh, that's pretty cool. I'll go to the scriptures now. Holy scriptures. I'm sure most of you are familiar with this. First of all, I delivered unto you that which I received, how that Christ died for our sins, agreeing to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he arose again the third day, according to the scriptures. So keep that faith in the gospel, except you have believed in vain. There are many witnesses to the resurrection. This is the gospel that Jesus Christ revealed to St. Paul the Apostle. And I'll scroll it down. Sorry about the black line on the whites doing that. Well, okay. Let's check out these documents. If you'd like me to just send them to you, you can send me an email at proverbsgold444@mail.com. Most of these are in the description right here. John 8:51. Verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my saying, he shall never see death. And then Colossians 1:27. to whom God would make known the glorious riches of this mystery among the Gentiles, which riches is Christ in you, the hope of glory. That Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, that ye being rooted and grounded in love. And there's more. Because ye are sons, God hath sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, which crieth, Abba, Father. Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no man cometh unto the Father but by me. There's many other ones there. I'll have to work for now. I hope you can read all the few other important documents. Check out this video. Go to this channel. You're going to have to type it in manually. Okay, make sure you share this part. It's pretty obvious by now. Trust in Jesus. Just trust Jesus, not man. We know that we are of God, and that the world is altogether set on wickedness. That's what it says, 1 John 5:19, I believe. Okay. Some solutions for your health. Check out this brother in Christ. Go to that link right there. He usually has this. You scroll down on his audio podcasts. Also check out his channel at Herbs Plus Beadworks on YouTube. Herbs Plus Beadworks. Herbs Plus Beadworks. Yourself some vitamin A. Pause that and read it. Tony's contact information. You can call him. He does free consultations. A phone call, Brother Tony. He's a believer in the living God. Just pardon some of his Canadian English. Salt of the earth English, as he calls it. Anyways, there's just different things going on there. This is like, I don't know, a few months old. This one that I copied here, pasted. Okay, yeah, just pray about everything. And then there's a few other things I'd like to share. About being prudent. Make sure you stay prudent during these last days. That's the definition from my 1947 Merriam-Webster's Collegiate Dictionary. Characterized by prudent means characterized by or manifesting prudence, specifically capable of directing or conducting oneself wisely and judiciously. Cautious, circumspect, or discreet, as in conduct, choice, or choice of ends, or business, management, not rash or ill-advised, highly sensible, prudently. Whatsoever thou takest in hand, remember the end, and thou shalt never do amiss. Or in other words, ask yourself honestly, what would Jesus Christ truly and righteously do, and you'll never make a mistake. Consider the end result of any potential choices or actions, and you will not make a mistake. Alright. So a few other documents I'd like to share. gonna have to be good for that one. Have some hope. Is all the occurrences of the word hope in the New Testament King James Holy Bible. God bless you. Hope abundantly, according to all of God's glorious riches in Christ Jesus. I'm going to read it. Of course, stay away from anything they're advertising on these commercials or on TV. Refuse, avoid anything they're wanting to put in people's arms, in their nose, or in their mouth, or anything like that. Anything artificial. It's not of nature. It's not created by God. Avoid. Just trust fully in God Almighty alone, and He shall keep you safe. Psalm 91:10. For no evil shall befall you, and no plague shall come nigh thy dwelling. For the Lord thy God is a light and a defense. The Lord will give grace and worship. No good thing will he withhold from them that live a godly life. Check out all those verses. Good. Write them down, and or just pause it and read them. I know it's kind of a lot. I'm the one that put them one by one on there to help you out eventually. And just a little bit more here to go. Hope you can read that. It might be going kind of fast. All right. This is St. William Tyndale's translation of 1537 Matthew's Holy Bible. Read a part of this, and pause that and read the rest. This is a good one to have memorized, 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Love suffereth long and is courteous. Love envieth not, love doth not frowardly, swalleth not, dealeth not dishonestly. Seeketh not her own, is not provoked to anger, thinketh not evil, rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth. Suffereth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth in all things. Though that prophesying fail, other tongues shall cease, or knowledge vanish away. This should be written there, because I memorized this. Though that prophesying fail, other tongues shall cease, or knowledge vanish away, yet love falleth never away. Yeah, I somehow made a mistake there. But anyways, just check it out, and there's one more, I believe, or two documents. This one is an important one. I spent some time compiling these holy scriptures. So they're being tried in the furnace of adversity, of tribulation, and being found faithful. Job, you know, there's all the apostles. Jesus Christ, Moses, Abraham. Until the time that his word, until the word of the Lord had tried him. All these about the same matter. This one's from an apocryphal book, or as it's called. That word apocrypha is not even in the 14 books. It's just a label. Means hidden or kept secret. I see that there is truth in these books. Just studying the New Testament first. With your patience, possess your souls. With your patience, possess your souls and see. That is, the soul is possessed, that is, perisheth not, but is saved by patience, if it through faith in Christ do patiently suffer all adversities. So keep on being patient and follow Jesus. He suffered and we follow his example. And then 41:2, John, portion chapter 12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, except that wheat corn fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone. If it die, it bringeth forth much fruit. He that loveth his life shall destroy it, and he that hateth his life in this world shall keep it unto life eternal. The footnote from the Matthew's Bible says, he that hateth his life in see, that is, he that can be content to lose his temporal life in this world for Christ's sake and his ward shall live forever, as in Matthew 10, Mark 8, Luke 9. So yeah, he that loveth his life shall destroy it, and he that hateth his life in this world shall keep it unto life eternal. So yeah, be willing to suffer for Christ and lose his temporal life, and you'll live forever. You know, just keep on trusting Jesus. Well, and you hate the life of sin, you know. And you hate this flesh. Flesh profiteth nothing, but the Spirit quickeneth. We're willing to suffer for Christ, and we'll reign with him in glory. So trust in Jesus. Follow his example. Read Ephesians chapter 6, about the full armor of God. These are good verses. Please read them, share them. God bless you. There's a little bit more I'd like to share. Patience. So that's pretty good. There's some verses about adoption. Alright. Let me check what else I have to share with you. This one, I spent the time to type, put it into the modern font for the people. This is in the 1537 Matthew's Holy Bible, the Deuterocanonical or Apocrypha, the Ecclesiasticus. Hope you can read that. So that's a chapter there. Hope you guys were able to pause it at certain parts. If not, there's one, two. Sorry about those black lines going up on the screen. So there's that. And I think I may have one more. Yeah, 2 Esther chapter 2. And type this out for you people. For other people too, originally. I got a part of this on one of my videos called Gospel and Rapture Holy Scriptures. Just pause it and read it. That and read it. God bless you people. If you stayed listening this long, thank you. You share this information. The horse is prepared against the day of battle, but safety is of the Lord, and the power of the Lord our God should be with them that seek him with their whole heart. It's from the third book of Esther, portion chapter 8. Just keep on seeking the Lord. He's always here with us. Dwells in our hearts by faith, and Jesus Christ is come in the flesh. I love you, brethren. I believe that's good enough for now, what I'll share with you. If you want to check out some links for Brother William Tyndale, I'll probably put this in the description box. Anyways, here they are. and download his New Testament of 1534. Those will be in the description sometime soon. God bless you. Love you, brethren. Share this video. And keep you in my prayers. God bless. God bless you all.